Friends, welcome back. Welcome back to the realm of art once more. In the last session, we have already talked about the value, the importance, not only that, the process of a work of art. So, in this section, we are dealing with two poems where the value of a work of art, the process of creation of it, and the different levels of importance of this work, any work of art, is highlighted. Two very beautiful poems are included in it. You who are already familiar with the special world an artist is in, the special importance that an artist attributes to a sensitive person who can really appreciate his work of art, the non-relevance for him of the material prospects, all these we have already noticed. So, let's move on to the great poem, a great piece of art again, The Master. See, Han Kan, a great artist, great Chinese artist of the 9th century AD, was summoned to the court. He was directed to sit at the feet of the court painter and enjoy or learn the art. You know what Han Kan did? Do you think he sat at the feet of the court painter and learned, mastered the art of painting? No. Han Kan was an artist. And in an artist's world, he is the king, no? So, what did he say? You should remember the line. What did he say? I will apprentice myself to the stables. I don't want to apprentice myself to the court painter. I am going to apprentice myself to the stables. A stable artist, no? So, what did he do? He set up a all artistic settings in the stable, among the dung, among the flies. See how the poet describes it? So, he set his ale among the dung and the flies, and then what did he do? Simply sat there enjoying the music of the flies and the aroma of the dung. No, why did he go there? He went there because he wanted to study the character of different horses, because he was planning to draw a horse, to paint a horse. So, what did he do? He observed carefully. Look what he noticed. One had sparkling eyes and the other very sensitive stance, and the third graceful movement. So, what had sparkling eyes did not have graceful movement. What had sensitive stance did not have sparkling eyes. Different horses had different great qualities. And being an artist, what is the greatest quality of an artist? Keen observation. He observed. Observed carefully. Observed carefully with angles where these specialities occur, or how he can express it. And he keenly studied these features and came up with the painting, The Night Shining White. The Night Shining White. Look at the usage. The Night Shining White. Did you like the name? It's so interesting. The moment we hear about it, night, it doesn't have any shine. So, night is there, shine is there, white is there. Don't you think only an artist can mix all these elements together? So, what are the qualities of night shining white? Perhaps sparkling eyes, sensitive stance, graceful movement, and the many minor qualities that Han Kan noticed in other horses. This made night shining white a special painting. Han Kan is remembered as the master of horse painting. Even now, painters study his art very carefully. Here we have that picture, the painting, night shining white. Sparkling eyes, graceful movement, stance of that horse, all those elements combined in this painting. We can notice it carefully. Hankan's Night Shining White is considered to be a masterpiece in horse painting. Why? What about the poem? Is it a masterpiece? What makes it a masterpiece? There is a reference in it. When Hankan was summoned to the palace, there was another court painter. What happened to him? Where is he? Is there any reference later to this particular painter in the poem again? Why could it be so? What's his name? Why his name is not even mentioned? So, do you think patronizing of art, it is needed? Art needs patronizing because art in itself doesn't generate any money. Artists, since they are the flag bearers of culture and civilization of human society, naturally they have to be patronized. But it's a probable question. Remember, they may ask you why? Why that court painter, he also might have been summoned, he also might have been patronized by the emperor, but he is never mentioned.